welcome to my channel or back to my channel. Thank you. If you have returned, I'm clearly doing something right. So today's video is a get ready with me, create this look, how I do my makeup on a daily basis type of thing. So if you're interested or intrigued in any way, please continue watching. Sitting here contemplating how in the world I'm going to make this video, that I got up at 9 a.m. and showered to make, and I have all of my makeup sitting out here. And I just realized, how can I film this if I don't have a mirror? Because I can't do this. This is just not gonna work for me. I found this. Don't think this is gonna work very well. Oh, this is gonna be really interesting. Well, I guess we'll just try it either way, see how it goes. But because everyone always wants me, I'm not saying, oh my God, yeah, everyone wants to know how to do my makeup, but I've got skilled. Oh, this is just not. Okay, here we go. So I don't have name brand makeup, a lot of it anyway. Most of it is from like CVS, drugstore, whatever. But then there are some things that I splurge on, mostly palettes. That's about it. The first thing I always use is this. It's, a primer that I just like put everywhere, and no, I do not know what in the world I am doing, nor do I care, as long as it all looks good in the end. It's not about the process, it's about the end result. If it looks good when I'm done, whatever. And then I have my Morphe palette. I literally just got this and it is my favorite thing in the entire world. I still have the color names on it because stuff like this, duh. I need to like tape it up at the top or something. I've seen a girl do that and I thought it was very interesting. So I am going to take Universal. Mm-hmm. And my mirror. Just put that up in here. Stop moving because you're gonna mess me up. I have blue eyes, so I automatically just think that this whole palette is going to look good. If you knock over this camera cat, I swear you're going to get so much trouble. And then sit still. I'm going to take Orb, this one, and I'm also going to put that in there just to darken it up. The bronzier, the better. And then I'm going to take, are you almost done? And then I'm going to take terracotta. Very, very middle right there. I'm going to take that and put it in the crease. Then we're going to go with Rich. This one, it's like a brownie tone. I'm going to put that on the outer corner and into the crease. I'm using this Morphe 433 brush, and literally my favorite thing. It was like $6, and I am so happy I got it, because before this, the only thing I was using was my Urban Decay one, and it's not a very blendy brush. And now I am going to take Pure, this little boy right there. I'm going to mix that with Tan, because they don't really, this one is just like a powder and it's not very pigmented like with this brush. And I'm just gonna put that here. Just got some in my eye. To make it a little more pigmented, I'm gonna take the Naked 2 palette. This one, I like to use this brush more for the sparkly colors, just because it's more of a pressed brush. And I sound like I know what I'm talking about, and I don't. You know what I'm getting at. It like lays the color on so much nicer when you're not a beauty guru and don't know what you're doing like me. That looks very orange. I'm gonna take Toast. And I'm going to add that to the outer corner and crease, because I feel like it's just a little too orange, and I like that a lot better. So much better. Okay, I'm going to take my Urban Decay flat brush again, and I'm going to take Foxy and Booty Call, and I use both of those as my highlight on my brow bone. And then I'm just going to blend all of this, because a not blended eyeshadow is a terrible eyeshadow. Last but not least, I'm going to take the short little stubby end of this brush, and I am going to take Toast again. I'm just going to put it right down in here on my lower lash line. Okay. Now, foundation. I do not pay a lot of money for foundation. I have had this, not even gonna say for how long. It is just the Maybelline New York Dream Liquid Mousse Airbrush Finish in Classic Ivory. Pretty sure that's not my color, but I make it work. And I have a specific brush that I don't know who it's by, because it doesn't have a label anywhere on it, that I use for my foundation applying. And then just kind of put it everywhere. Excuse you and your foot. Morai, stop. Wow, I am like noticing how weird of faces I make, and that I watch so many YouTube videos and all of these people are like, oh, don't stretch your eyes because you'll get wrinkles. It's fine. So what we have anti-wrinkle cream for that I put on before all of this. So it's probably counteractive. So that means that if I don't have wrinkles now, I won't get wrinkles later. Probably not. Now for my under eye, I do have redder cheeks, and I really don't like that because normally there's one that's more red than the other, and so normally I would use this to cover it up. This is the Maybelline Fit Me in Fair. I have this one in light, and there's definitely a color difference. I definitely like fair better because it's lighter and it looks better. So I just put that under here. I am going to try my very hardest to take my Revlon Revlon Colorstay Skinny Liquid Liner. Now I need the utmost quiet for this, and I need to get really close. So if you don't mind me for just a second. Oh, already messed up. I would say that's not absolutely terrible. I feel I have done worse in my time. You gotta love when one eye turns out different than the other. Especially when one turns out better than the other, like this one. Honestly, I don't think it's that terrible. This is honestly probably the best I have ever done on eyeliner. Literally ever. That wing though. So good. That one. Now, I am going to take my powder. Oh, I use the Revlon Colorstay in light because I'm pale. I don't do things properly. I'm taking my Anastasia contour kit. Don't mind how scratched up it is. That is user damage and wear. This is light to medium. It's a little messy. Don't mind that. I'm going to take this. I don't know where I got this. I think I got this in a makeup brush thing that I got from my aunt a long time ago. I don't know what company has a rose looking thing on it, but whatever company that is, that's what brush this is from. Estee Lauder, I think that's what this is. Maybe, I don't know. So I'm gonna take these two colors right here, and I'm just going to put it right here in my Reese bone, no bone area. And I'm also going to put that up here. I know a lot of YouTubers know, you know, where they're supposed to be highlighting and contouring, and I definitely do not. I do not contour my nose because my nose is stupid. I have a stupid nose. It is dry and oily at the same time, and there's nothing that I know how to do to solve it. So, since I don't want my nose to look dumb, I don't fix it that way at all. And now I'm taking my Laura Geller Baked Gelato Swirl Illuminator right there. And this is in Gilded Honey. I am absolutely in love with this. Absolutely in love with it. I use this all the time. This is actually the only highlighter I have besides whatever is in this palette right here. And so I take that same brush, wiped off, whatever, it does the job, and put that on my cheekbones. This is what it looks like for anyone who is wondering. It's just very like golden and adorable, and it's great. And maybe if I just applied it with my fingers, it would come out better. There we go. I make this face like I'm a freaking turtle. Like it actually matters. If it like, I don't know. Okay, anyway. I go back in with this.
Pressed powder.
Pressed powder. And I take it on this and I just put it on my lower jawbone. My lower jawbone. Yep, that's what it is. And that kind of like highlights that, I guess. And then I just blend it because I don't want to be one of those girls. Okay, I had to go get my Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray because this stuff is literally amazing. And yes, I have boxes for everything. Just X. Probably not supposed to do this either, but I'm impatient. And then I have to do my eyelashes. One momento. Super. My little sisters got me this, so thank you to them. Raislin, Raylia, thank you. Or whichever one of you that it was. We'll just say it was both of you. So now I use the Maybelline. I have a lot of, never mind, no I don't. Maybelline and Revlon are normally what I feel that I use a lot of. This is the Maybelline Great Lash in Blackest Black because I like my lashes long and black. I do this a certain way. I've seen someone do this on someone once and it literally was amazing where they just like raise the... I understand why you don't do that now. Okay, well, we're just gonna do it the normal way then because screw that for right now. I like this because then I can hide my stupid face that I'm making. I'm actually very proud of this look. Like, this is actually like really nice. Compared to like what I feel like I normally do, but this is normally what I do, but it just looks better than when I normally do it. Okay, all good. And then I take my L'Oreal Brow Style Frame and Set in Light Brunette. And with this little brush that it gives me, and I just do my eyebrows. I don't know how to do eyebrows. I know how to fill them in, if that's what do them means. Does that look better? I feel like it does. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, I'm sure you will enjoy many of my other ones. So I'll see you in the next one. I hope you enjoyed.